Hello? Okay. Hi. Thank you, everyone, for being here tonight. Thank you for coming out. The first piece you heard was the sixth movement of Heitor Villa-Lobos' Pequena Suite, which is a suite written for cello. There are six movements. That was the finale. It's a wonderful, wonderful piece of music that goes through all the different styles that a cellist can play. And the last one is really fun for the euphonium player. Lots of finger moving and a lot of high notes. So it was a fun, big challenge, and just something small that I wanted to do. The next piece I'm going to play for you is a cello sonata, the Melanie Bonis cello sonata in F. It's a glorious piece of music. Really, really rich music with big themes, and works really well for the euphonium. Of course, sounds great on the cello, but there are some really great stuff in here for the euphonium player as well. So after the sonata, we'll take a brief intermission. But before that, I hope you enjoy Melanie Bonis' cello sonata.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, everyone, for coming out again. I do greatly appreciate to see everyone here in the audience, as well as my family members who are watching on the live stream. I do greatly appreciate your love and support and being here tonight, spending a Monday night listening to a euphonium recital. That's pretty cool. Would also like to thank a big, big, big thank you to Dr. J. DeWire, my excellent accompanist tonight. If you couldn't tell, that last piece had some pretty gnarly piano stuff in it. So he's been awesome, and it's always a pleasure to work with. The first three pieces tonight, the Villa-Lobos, the Boni, and then the Bourgeois, were intended to be performed last spring. Unfortunately, I got sick, so had to cancel it. So I'm really grateful that Jay was able and willing to come back and do this again and risk me not getting sick this time. So I do greatly appreciate that. The last piece I'm going to play for you tonight is a real showpiece, if the other pieces tonight haven't been. The last piece is titled Pantomime. This is like the euphonium's Beethoven 5. It's the Rachmaninoff 2nd. It's like the most standard thing we have in our repertoire, and is really, really just a really fun piece of music. Philip Sparke is a great composer. He's written a number of works for wind band, brass band, solo instruments, brass instruments, you name it, he's written it. He's a fantastic composer, has written a number of pieces for our instrument, as a real champion of our instrument. Pantomime is really kind of in two movements. Pantomime, if you're unaware, comes from the Italian comedic dell'arte, which is an old Italian stage style, almost like two-faced, and you'll hear that in the music, where the first half of the piece is slow and very melodic, while the second half is a dance, and then it finishes with the finale. I'm going to play tonight in an abbreviated version. Philip Sparke wrote this piece in 1986, and it was what you're going to hear tonight. But then in 1992, after significant amounts of popularity in the euphonium community, he reworked it and rewrote it, added a couple phrases, and made it about like three-ish minutes longer. But what you're going to hear tonight is the bare bones and everything you need to hear. So again, thank you so much for coming out here tonight. I look forward to seeing you guys after, and please enjoy Pantomime by Philip Sparke.
Mm-hmm.